Hello students, good morning all. Today we are going to study about another important civilization, that is Mesopotamian civilization. Today also your class is going to start by your beloved friend Nura. Okay, so we can hear what are the words of Nura. Nura, please come and present your points here.
Hi friends, good morning. It's me, Nura Fatima. Today we are going to discuss some important points about Mesopotamian civilization. The word Mesopotamia means the land between two rivers. Do you know which were these two rivers? They were Euphrates and Tigris. So the Mesopotamia lies between Euphrates and Tigris. The Mesopotamian civilization flourished in the region where the northern Iraq is situated. Four different civilizations were emerged and declined in Mesopotamia. They were the Sumerian, the Babylonian, the Assyrian and Chaldean. Because of the presence of two important rivers, the soil here was so fertile. So the people here were engaged in different agricultural works. When the agriculture started, the trade also started in increases. Then it resulted in the emergence of new cities like Ur, Uruk and Lagash were the major cities of Mesopotamia. The Mesopotamian people have trade relation between Harappan people. You know that when the trade developed, it resulted in the development of new art of writing. Now we are going to study about the important features of Mesopotamian states. The system of writing is called a cuneiform. Cuneiform were wedge-shaped. They were written on a smooth surface of a wet clay tablets. They used a sharp stylus for writing. Okay? So, for writing, Mesopotamians used sharp pointed stylus. The picture of cuneiform here. Now we can study the scientific properties of Mesopotamian people. The Mesopotamian people achieved a remarkable progress in the field of maths and astronomy. They knew division, multiplication and square root. They formulated a calendar and divided a year into 12 months and a month into 4 weeks and a day into 24 hours. The Mesopotamian pupils were very famous in their architectural skills also. They constructed a particular temple and it's known as Ziggurat. Ziggurats were the best examples for their architectural skills, and ziggurats were built on artificial hillocks using bricks. Now, you can see the picture of ziggurat here. I hope all of them understand my class. Thank you.
Okay, congrats Nora, because you have presented your points here very well. Now, I think that you have got a clear picture about Mesopotamian civilization. Okay, so you please see which are the important points related with Mesopotamian civilization. Okay, start. What's the first point? Yes, Mesopotamian civilization, it flourished Euphrates and Tigris. Okay, so we can say Mesopotamian civilization, it flourished with the help of two important rivers, which were the Euphrates and Tigris. Okay, the next point please. Yeah, what's that? Mesopotamia means the land between two rivers. Okay, the land between two rivers. Clear? So, first point, once again, Mesopotamian civilization, it flourished in between two rivers, which are the Euphrates and Tigris. And the word Mesopotamia means the land between two rivers. Then, next point. What's that? Okay, there were some other four important civilizations flourished in this area and they declined because of so many reasons. Okay, so which were the famous other civilizations? First one, Sumerian. Okay, first one Sumerian, next one Babylonian, then next one, yes, Assyrian, and the next one, yes, Chaldean. Okay, so these were four other important civilizations that also emerged here, but because of so many reasons, these four civilizations declined. Okay, so you are going to study, you have to study only Mesopotamian civilization. Then you know that this civilization developed in the presence of two important rivers. So you know that because of the presence of Euphrates and Tigris, the soil of this area was more fertile. So when the soil was more fertile, what will be the main occupation of the people? Yes, what's that? Agriculture. Okay, so we can say agriculture was the main occupations of the Mesopotamian people. Then in the Arabian civilization you studied, when agriculture developed automatically, one other thing also developed. What's that? Yes, trade developed. So when agriculture developed, excess agriculture products will be there. So it automatically paved the way for the development of trade. So when trade increased, they have to calculate the day-to-day calculations. Okay, so it became or it resulted the invention of art, or we can say writing. Not art, the invention of writing. Okay, so now we are going to study which is the important, or which was the important art form of Mesopotamian people. Then can you say what was that? Yes, what's the name of that? Cuneiform. Okay, so cuneiform. Cuneiform was the important art form of Mesopotamian people. And now we are going to study what are the important features of cuneiform script. Then you please say what was the important points related with cuneiform script. Yes, first one, yeah, first one, it has wedged shape. Okay, wedged shape, that means not smooth shape, some zigzags in the writing. So we can say wedged shape. Then they use a particular nail model thing, or we can say style or stylus for writing this one. Okay, so the cuneiform script was in wedged shape, and they used some particular nail model thing to write these letters. Okay, then you have already seen the pictures of this writing. Clear? Then they wrote that pictures in clay tablets. Tablets means one square model, a particular bricks, and they write their things on that clay model, and after that they dry it with the help of sunlight. Okay, so these were the important points related with the cuneiform script. Once again, the scripts had the shape of wedge shape, and they used some particular pointed thing to write the ideas, and they had written their points on clay tablets, and after writing the ideas, they burn it, or we can say they dry it with the help of sunlight. Okay, then now we studied when agriculture increased, it paved the way for the development of trade, and the trade created the necessity of writing, etc. And you know that when the trade increased, it also helped to increase some cities also, or to develop some cities also. So you please note the important cities of Mesopotamia. Can you name which are they? Yes, which are they? Yes, Ur. Next one, Uruk. Next one, Lagos. Okay, so these were the famous cities of Mesopotamia. So once again, please note Ur, Uruk, and Lagash. So please note this. Okay, then they had got some important progress in the development of science and astronomy. Okay, so the mathematics field also, mathematics also, they divided 1 year into 12 months. They divided because they prepared a particular calendar, and according to that calendar, one year has 12 months, and each month has 4 weeks. 4 weeks, and they divided one day into 24 hours. Clear.
So they have prepared a particular type of calendar, and according to that calendar, 12 months are the, and each month has 4 weeks, and they divide one day into 24 hours. Then, in the case of mathematics, they had the idea about division. They had the idea about division, then multiplication. Multiplication and square root. Square root. Clear? So these are the important scientific progress. So please note this. Then one more point. You know that they prepared calendar. It is on the basis of the movement of the moon. Okay. So please note that point also. They prepared calendar on the basis of the movement of the moon. Clear? Okay, now we can study what was their art progress in architecture. Okay, they constructed some particular temples. The name of that temples is ziggurat. Okay, the name of the temple was ziggurat, and they constructed that ziggurat in cities, and they created artificial hillocks and made this or constructed this ziggurat or the shape of temples by using bricks. Okay, so these are the important points related to ziggurat. So ziggurat was a best example for the architectural skill of Mesopotamian people, and they constructed these temples in cities, and they constructed these temples by using bricks. Okay, so these are the important points related with Mesopotamian civilization. Now the last point in this chapter, that is Chinese civilization. Okay, now we can study Chinese civilization. Chinese civilization. Okay, this civilization, before starting this class, we can hear the words of Aisha Tasneem. She is ready to present her points related with Chinese civilization. Okay, so please come and present your points.
Hi friends, good morning. It's me, Aisha Tasneem. Here I am going to say some important points related with Chinese civilization. This civilization flourished in the river valley of Huaihua. Agriculture was their important occupation. Other people engaged in weaving, making pottery and silk production. They had their own script. It was pictographic, not alphabetic. They had their own calendar. It had 365 and a half days. Let me stop here. Thank you. Bye bye.
Okay. Congrats, Aisha Tasneem. You have also presented your topics here very well. Okay. So I'm going to conclude that topics, that important points, because it's a small part, so easy for you to study. This civilization flourished Huaihua River Valley. Okay, Huaihua. Then you know that here also the civilization flourished in the river banks. So because of that, the soil was so fertile one. So can you say which was the important occupation of the people? Yes, it's also agriculture. So we can say agriculture was the main occupation of the people. Then some other people engaged in weaving, then pottery works, and silk production. You know that the China silk, which is world famous. Okay, so these are the important occupations for the people during that period in China. So which were they? Agriculture was the main occupation, and some other people engaged in weaving, pottery and silk products. Okay, making silk products. Then next point, you know that now we studied hieroglyphic script, then cuneiform script. Likewise, Chinese people have also developed a particular model of writing. But this writing was totally in picture. So we can say this writing was in pictographic, or we can say picture model. Okay, there was no script at that time. Then later they changed some arrangements in their writing, and now we can say there is some difference from the old model and the present model. Okay, then Chinese people also prepared a particular type of calendar, and in that calendar, 1 year is equal to 365.5 days. Clear? So these are the important points related with Chinese civilization. First one, this civilization flourished in the riverbank of Huanghe, and agriculture was the main occupation, and other occupations were weaving, then pottery work, and the production of making of silk products. Okay, then next one, their script was in picture shape, or we can say picture and graphic model. There was no script at that time, and they prepared a calendar, and that calendar had 365.5 days. Okay, now we are going to conclude this chapter, and you can easily understand some common features of this civilization, because each and every civilization, you know that the important occupation of the people was agriculture. Okay, then all these civilization together known as one particular age. Anybody know that? Yeah, Bronze Age, because the people used bronze during this age, and they prepared their own script. And each civilization, they had remarkable progress or development in the field of architecture. Okay, architecture. So development in agriculture, then development in the field of science and maths, then in the development in the use of bronze, these are the important features of all these civilizations. Okay, so that is the end of this chapter. So study very well. If you have any doubt, you can contact. Okay, thank you.